Welcome to Daily Armor. Today's verse will be coming from Matthew chapter 5 and verse number 13. You've got your Bibles, read along with me. Matthew chapter 5, verse number 13 says, "Ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt have lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is thenceforth good for nothing but to be cast out and to be trodden underfoot of men." When you think about salt, and we're the salt, we are described as the salt of the earth. Salt has so many uses. We use salt to flavor food. We use salt to preserve food. Our body needs salt. I'm one of those people who I don't really have just a natural drive for salt. Anybody all my children know that when I cook, you're going to have to add some more salt because they all like salt way more than I do. So I salt like I like it, and then they always add some more. But we need salt for flavor. One of those things that I like to eat is an egg. But that's one of those things that I am going to put salt on because I don't like an egg without salt. And there's many types of food that we eat that we probably wouldn't even eat it if it wasn't for adding a little salt to it. Or in some cases, some people like a lot of salt. You think about we use salt on the roads when it's wintertime and the roads get icy. We're from North Carolina, so maybe some of my friends in Florida don't understand that concept. But when things are icy, when the steps are icy, I would throw out some salt onto the driveway or onto the steps going in and out of the house. Use salt for our filter system at home. We have a well water and it runs through a water softener, and I buy salt every month, and I add salt to that filtration system, and what it does is it's helping the water to filter out some of those impurities. It's cleaning that filtration system. So we use salt in so many things. Our body needs salt. I know those that have high blood pressure, they need to lower their sodium intake, they need to lower their salt, but salt is still vital for the body. It affects our nerves, it affects our muscles. For those, like most of the men in my family, work in the heat, they have to make sure that they are replenishing that. So we buy sports drinks, things like that. The main source of that is going to be those salt minerals to put back in that body because they have sweated off so much that they'll start cramping up, they'll start being fatigued, and they need to put some of that back in there. So if you think about all the uses for salt, and the Lord says, Jesus says, we are the salt of the earth, then it sounds like we're pretty important. We're pretty vital. And he's talking about here, it says, but if the salt have lost his savor, then it's henceforth good for nothing. So we have to be useful. And God has put a talent, a purpose in each and every one of us. So I'm here for a purpose, you're here for a purpose, and we need to live out that purpose. So we don't want to be that salt that is not being used, that salt that's staying in the cabinet and it's getting stale. We want to be useful. And to be useful just means you do what the Lord talented you to do. And just like all the different kinds of salt and the different reasons for salt and the different uses for salt, we're all different. We're all made different. We all have different purposes. So we're not like a bunch of robots and we're all doing the same thing. We all have different things that we're supposed to do. And because we all do different things, then we affect the world and those around us in different ways. And maybe like that... those that when we use salt to preserve food, when it's, you salt the meat and to preserve it, or you put salt in the canned foods to preserve the food that way, that we are used out in the world as a preservative. We might be used as a world out in the world just like melting off some salt or melting off some ice. That maybe we're melting that cold heart. Maybe we're melting that icy heart, that person who's not responsive to the Lord Jesus Christ, that are not, they're not in the Word. They don't even have a desire for it. But there's something about you that puts that desire in their heart. There's something about your life and about how you act and about how you react to things that they are drawn to you, and that they kind of, they're that person that comes to you that is not a believer, but yet something happens in their life and they say, but I'm going to call so and so because I know she'll pray. I'm going to call such and such down there, my neighbor that lives down the road, because I know they go to church and I know that they'll pray. So we are used in so many different ways and different fashions that we are vital to this world. We are to be doing what God wants us to do in whatever way that He has chosen for us to do that. We can provide balance for that person who maybe is in an unbalanced situation. Maybe we provide some kind of situation that's kind of gotten volatile, and when the Lord tells us to be those peacemakers, maybe we're that person who is providing balance in that situation, and we're trying to be that person who lets them see it from a different perspective. So I'll challenge us today that no matter what kind of salt you are, no matter what kind of salt that the Lord has made me to be, to go out there and start salting different areas in our life. So be like salt and use our abilities to bring a little flavor. Now, we know that too much salt is bad for us, but we have to have solid salt, and we have to have balance, and we provide that for the things that go on in this world. And we are useful. God's got a very specific plan and purpose for you, and I challenge you to pray and ask Him exactly how that He wants you to be used, and what kind of salt are you. Thank you for joining me. Look forward to seeing you again soon.